On Thursday, 3rd April, while I was on business in Europe, I learned of the sudden passing of Dr. J.S. Archibald QC, known to many of us as simply Archie. Although I have commented on this great loss through other media, given Dr. Archibald's immense contribution to the socio-economic development of this territory, on behalf of the government and the people of this territory, I'd like to publicly recognize his legacy and pay tribute to this BVI icon. Archie's association with the BVI started in the 60s, when he served this territory as Crown Attorney, now titled Attorney General. At the time, the Crown Attorney, besides being a member of both the Executive and Legislative Councils, was also the Director of Public Prosecutions and the Chief Legal Advisor to Government, amongst a myriad of other responsibilities. He served in that capacity with distinction for several years before returning to his native St. Kitts to serve in a similar capacity. On returning to the BVI a few years later, where he lived until his untimely passing, Dr. Archibald opened his private practice and served his community brilliantly in every conceivable area of law, whether in civil or criminal litigation, commercial or constitutional law, international arbitration, banking, property, insolvency, appellate work, and much more. The breadth of his practice was truly unprecedented. His clients were always confident in the full knowledge that once Archie was representing them, he would do so passionately yet clinically and get them the best judgment possible in any court of law, including the Privy Council. Archie really gave his best advice to successive governments and constitutional as well as on any other issue when asked. Like his clients, government leaders could rest assured that the advice received was not given lightly, but was based on solid research, knowledge, and experience. He was a founding member of the Board of Governors of the H. Lafferty Stout Community College and served as the college's legal counsel up to his passing. He also served as chairman of the BVI Telecommunications Regulatory Commission. A man of the highest integrity, we are most grateful for his unswerving commitment to serving his territory and his people to the best of his ability during his lifetime. Together with the late McQuillan Todman, Dr. Archibald made history by becoming the first BVI lawyers to receive silk from Her Majesty the Queen. In the courtroom, Archie was a formidable advocate, a force to be reckoned with. His very physical presence commanded attention. His encyclopedic knowledge of the law, together with his great persuasive skills, made him not only renowned for delivering excellence, but revered in the profession. Besides distinguishing himself as a brilliant jurist, he served on several occasions as a judge of the OECS Supreme Court. Many years later, the University of the West Indies recognized his contribution to law in the region by conferring on him a PhD in law. Several of our outstanding younger BVI lawyers, including our own Chief Justice Janice George Pereira, Jerry Ferrara QC, Sidney Bennett QC, and others, started out at his chambers before establishing their own practices. Their individual accomplishments are a testimony to the kind of mentoring that they received from Dr. Archibald. But he was not only a role model for BVI lawyers, he was equally so for the entire profession. As I said through social media, Archie was possessed of a towering intellect that made him one of the best legal minds of his generation in the region. He loved the law and had left an indelible footprint not only here at home, but in the wider Caribbean region and beyond. Possessed of a great pioneering spirit, Archie was not afraid of change and was always finding different ways to strengthen the legal profession, locally and across the region. His strong moral and ethical principles led him to be a founding member of the BVI Bar Association and founding president of the OECS Bar Association. In the latter capacity, he shaped guidelines for practicing barristers and solicitors of the Eastern Caribbean Supreme Court. A staunch Methodist, Dr. Archibald's contribution to his church throughout the region was legendary. His wise counsel was sought on all legal issues. I recall his being away for extended periods serving his church. But as brilliant and accomplished as he was, there was also the lighter side to him. He loved to dance. He'd be the first and the last person on the dance floor every time, with his flawless dance moves. Equally, Archie loved music, good books, and had many good stories to tell. He read voraciously, so much so that I often wondered with his caseload whether he ever slept. You would have noticed that I referred to Dr. J.S. Archibald QC at times as Archie. I do so with the utmost respect, as I have never gotten used to the formalities associated with his name. You see, despite his many accomplishments, he remained a humble man, an ordinary man. Indeed, as I reflect on his very rich legacy, I remember a true patriot who walked to kings but never lost the common touch. As we say our last farewell to Archie later this week, we are grateful to God for giving the BVIA the gift of this talented man. We are grateful to God that Archie passed his way. We are grateful to God that the BVIA is a better place because of his contribution to this territory. On behalf of the government and the people of the Virgin Islands, I extend my deepest sympathy to his wife, Deputy Governor Mrs. Ines Archibald, their three daughters, Patricia, Faye, and Ava, and the rest of the family. May God grant you comfort and peace during this time.